the Golden Isles for 115 years.
Beachview Event Rentals and Design is a full-service event company
with a resolution to provide clients with innovative inventory,
ideas,
and customer service. Our carefully curated collection of tents, lighting, linens, furniture, and tableware are sure to bring your vision to life and create a truly memorable event. The Beachview crew makes sure to bring the creativity, fun, and excellent customer service that has been winning us the appreciation and respect of all our clients for 20 years to each project.
Darien's Fun Waterfront Dining Experience, serving fresh seafood, steaks, and barbecue. Visit our website at skippersfishcamp.com.
You love the game, but you don't love the pain. From the moment an injury sidelines you, turn to the experts at Summit Sports Medicine and Orthopaedic Surgery. Our winning team of physicians and orthopaedic surgeons will design a treatment plan just for you, so you can get back in the game quickly and safely. To play your best, you need to work with the best. Visit sghs.org/summit or call 912-466-7340 to schedule your appointment.
Fields pass intended.
Back here at the Richard Hull Sports Center, St. Simons Island, Georgia, 6-0 Frederica Academy leading Brantley County. And Kevin, while we were away on break, they wasted no time. Frederica Academy, an onside kick, they recover and they're threatening again here in the first quarter.
Yes, when times are tough at Brantley, they're really tough. They've had some special team mistakes all year. They gave up a punt return for a touchdown last week, I think, and have given up some kickoff returns this year. And another special teams mistake there. They could not recover an onside kick, and Frederica back in business again on Brantley's side of the field, looking to punch in another touchdown.
So right now at the 24-yard line, again threatening, here's the snap to Veal, the toss to Triplett. Triplett tries to get to the outside, gets across the 20, inside the close to the 15-yard line. And once again, Frederica Academy threatening here with a 6-0 lead.
Yeah, Triplett, if you missed our pregame, Triplett, just a freshman. He is actually Frederica's leading ball carrier on the season with just over 200. The 30-rushing Kyle Perez was supposed to be the workhorse for Frederica in the backfield this year, but he is on the sidelines after injuring his leg in the previous game. But Triplett going to have to carry the mail at least for a couple of weeks here for Frederica. As you see the penalty on the Knights, that will back him up. But Triplett, a good-looking kid as a freshman.
6-0 Frederica Academy, 2:21 to go. And again, threatening to put some more points up on the board. Triplett in the backfield. Veal out of the shotgun. Triplett to his right. Here's the snap. Two steps back. Chased out of the pocket. Pressure, and he's going down. Nice job there. You saw 33 in on the tackle. That was DB Michael Connor. And a loss of yards there for Frederica Academy.
Connor
7 minutes to go here in the first quarter.
Yeah, even though Brantley down on the scoreboard here early and the defense has kind of been put in two tough situations here early in the ball game, one thing you can see right now is they are winning the battle up front. They have kind of spent some time in the offensive backfield here early on, so that's a positive sign as they've been put in some tough situations by their offense and their special teams here early in the ball game.
Snap coming up here to Veal again. Veal, play action, again going to throw down here to the near sideline, and it is incomplete. Intended receiver that time was Jaden Rose Scally, the senior wide receiver.
Intended for Jaden Rose, incomplete.
Just a little tidbit there. Jaden Rose is the grandson of the great George Rose. George Rose was a star player at Glenn Academy back in the late 50s, and he went on to play at Auburn and also played in the NFL with the Minnesota Vikings. He was around during the Purple People Eaters time and also played with the New Orleans Saints and the San Francisco 49ers.
So that'll bring on Eli Fritchman. And he's going to punt the football. That drive, although it looked promising at the start with the onside kick recovery, has stalled out. There's a snap. Fields it nicely as it takes a quick bounce off the grass. Back deep is Walker and Middleton. The ball will take a bounce right there at the 15, and they will down it right at the 10-yard line. So a nice punt there by Fritchman. Once again, Kevin, Brantley County, not a whole lot of room to work with. Better than their first possession offensively, but not ideal.
Right, and you got to give credit to the defense there for making the good stand. And basically after a positive play to start that drive by Frederica, the Brantley defense, of course, gets the sack in the backfield, and then Frederica hurts themselves with penalties and goes back behind the chains. So, again, yeah, now the story is, can this Brantley County offense move the football? They have struggled to score all season long through their first four ball games. Again, only 13 points in four ball games.
All right, 6-0 Frederica Academy leading Brantley County here in the first quarter. We're back after this timeout.
Let's get back to business together. Ameris Bank is committed to providing tools you need to do business today. Contactless payment, remote deposit, e-commerce platforms, and more. We're here to make sure you have what you need to operate in today's climate. Learn more at amerisbank.com/backtobusiness.
Golden Isles for 115 years.
Beachview Event Rentals and Design is a full-service event company
with a resolution to provide clients with innovative inventory, ideas, and customer service. Our carefully curated collection of tents, lighting, linens, furniture, and tableware are sure to bring your vision to life and create a truly memorable event. The Beachview crew makes sure to bring the creativity, fun, and excellent customer service that has been winning us the appreciation and respect of all our clients for 20 years to each project.
Darien's Fun Waterfront Dining Experience, serving fresh seafood, steaks, and barbecue. Visit our website at skippersfishcamp.com.
You love the game, but you don't love the pain. From the moment an injury sidelines you, turn to the experts at Summit Sports Medicine and Orthopaedic Surgery. Our winning team of physicians and orthopedic surgeons will design a treatment plan just for you, so you can get back in the game quickly and safely. To play your best, you need to work with the best. Visit sghs.org/summit or call 912-466-7340 to schedule your appointment.
Back here at St. Simon's Island, snap to Walker on third down, and it'll be a quarterback keeper. He's going to plow ahead, see if he got enough for a first down there. I believe he was shy on that attempt. 6-0, Frederica leading Brantley County. And so the punter for Brantley County is on to kick the football away. That's 98, Diego Martinez. A correction, Cameron Allen, who's averaging 33 yards per punt. There's the snap, just gets it away. Back deep on punt returns is Jaden Rose. And we'll check the marker there for Frederica Academy as they come out to start their third possession on offense. They lead 6-0.
Yeah, and Frederica, of course, threw the long TD pass to start the game and then went backwards on their second drive. They have benefited from good field position so far to start this ball game, and they'll have decent field position here again so far. Now, Dave, I know you're not exactly as familiar with these two teams as I am, but Frederica in the past has liked to move fast, but there's still no huddling this year, and they're looking at these wristbands, but they're not moving as quite as fast as they have in the past.
Pass out into the wing is complete. And a few extra yards after the catch there on the reception. It is caught there by Mason McGraw, the senior. That's his eighth catch of the year. Came in with seven for 66 yards. Still looking for that first touchdown, but a nice play there by Frederica Academy as they move the football. And again, they've got good field position. They've had good field position since the opening kickoff tonight. And we'll bring up second
down.
And again,
I thought Brandon Derrick may be a little more aggressive with his play calling as Bill settles in at the quarterback spot. He was conservative in the first two games, and he turned Bill loose in game three, and he's doing it again here tonight early.
Fritchman in motion here to the near side. The pass is complete. That's Bryce Riley, the junior, his third catch of the year. And we'll see if that's good enough for a first down. I believe that it is. Nice pass there by Veal to Riley.
And so far, of course, they hit the vertical pass for the touchdown of over 30 or close to 25, 30 yards. These are the screen passes and so forth out in the flats. But look for Coach Derrick to call more vertical routes as we go through this ball game and try to hit the home run passes on the Herons as well.
Tackle there by 48 for Brantley County. That's the linebacker, R.J. Bryan. So again, Veal out of the shotgun. Looks like a pistol formation with Triplett lining up behind him. There's the snap. They're going to hand it off. Triplett going to run over here to the near side toward the Frederica bench. He'll get tripped up. Good for a couple of yards on that play there for the Knights.
Third and five.
I think that was Dylan Carswell, a freshman for the Herons, with a nice open field tackle there to possibly stop a big game.
Six nothing Frederica Academy. The early lead on that touchdown pass from Veal to Fritchman. Right now from the just outside the 25, it's going to be a busted play. Veal is going to have to scramble. And he is going to end up getting tackled. On the stop there for Brantley County was 33, Little Michael Connor.
And Dave, you can see the middle of this Brantley County defensive front really getting a good push. They're winning that battle in the trenches right now, pushing those interior offensive linemen for the Knights straight backwards, right into the quarterback Billy. Really had nowhere to go, and the Herons are really looking good, getting a good push up front right now early in this ball game.
So they spot the ball at the 26, another good opportunity here for Frederica Academy. As Veal will take the snap out of the shotgun, timeout has been called. And it was called by Frederica Academy.
Ladies and gentlemen.
And so again, good field position here for the Knights, and they want to talk about it with their head football coach, Brandon Derrick. Kevin.
Yeah, you know, one interesting thing, I don't know if this is necessarily the case here, Dave, but, you know, both of these coaches, of course, we mentioned it, you know, as we came on right here, good buddies. They've coached together for many years. They were at Glenn Academy together from, you know, right around, let me get my notes here. They were at Glenn Academy together from, I think, around 2009 till coming over at Frederica at around 2013. And then, of course, Cannon left in 2017 to take an assistant job back in Cobb County, where he's from, at Allatoona. He was only there for 1 year before coming back to South Georgia and taking the job at Brantley County. But they run similar offenses with, you know, calling their plays and whatnot by some of the same things. And I think both teams maybe had to change some of their play calls. And so that could be causing some confusion for the Knights here. And that might be why they had to call a timeout there.
So here's the snap. Veal going to fire a quick screen pass. And
pick off.
It was picked off, intercepted, and running it back for a touchdown for Brantley County. All the way, going to tie the football game at six.
R.J.
And the interception of the pick six return is 48. The linebacker, R.J. Bryan. And Veal is intercepted. We got a tie ball game, Kevin, at six.
Yes. Hey, when you can't score offensive touchdowns, you got to find a way to put the ball in the end zone another way. And a big play there by the Brantley defense as we watch the replay. Great athletic play there by R.J. Bryan. He sat back there, read the pass. Probably a poor decision there by Veal. And the junior linebacker tight end for Brantley just stepped in front of the pass, and he had green grass in front of him all the way to the end zone. And as you see, it looks like they missed their point there, but maybe we had a penalty.
I believe that Fritchman was the intended receiver. And we do have a penalty. I believe it is against Frederica Academy. Take another look.
On the Knights.
Did they decline the penalty? And we got a 6-6 ball game. Attempting the point after is Diego Martinez. There's the snap. And the kick is up. And
kick is good by Diego Martinez.
It is good. And Brantley County on a pick six and a PAT has taken a 7-6 lead. Let's take another look. Veal out of the shotgun. I believe Fritchman, as we'll see, was the intended receiver. Bounced off of his fingertips, and Brian was right there. Long return, no opportunity for anybody in Forest Green for Frederica Allen to catch him.
Yeah, and you can see what happened, too. Also a good play there by number 57, Will Mason, the junior lineman. He got his big paws up there, and I think Bill was probably trying to deliver that ball over his head and trying to avoid him and maybe slightly overthrew that ball and also maybe a little bit out of reach of Fritchman. And it was kind of like Brian was back there playing center field, if you will, and, you know, manning his spot back there behind Fritchman, and he makes the play. And then, like I said, just green grass right in front of him. And R.J. Bryan is one of their leading tacklers with 27 tackles and several for loss. But he comes up with the big play there to hopefully give this Brantley County team some juice. Obviously, without scoring many points on the season, they really haven't led many ball games this year, if any at all. So when you can't score on offense, you got to score on defense. That was a big play for Brantley there.
Diego Martinez, who just kicked the PAT, will kick it off. A short kick. I think they were trying to play a little bit of that same game that Frederica Academy was playing. A short kick that bounced up, but the Knights were able to recover the football. And again, they're going to have what we would call decent field position right now. Frederica Academy trailing it by a 7-6 score here as we begin to get late in the first quarter.
And Dave, just for the record, that was a 75-yard interception return for the touchdown.
So Brian's pick six ties the game. The PAT makes it a one-point advantage for Brantley County. And time is called by Frederica Academy with 1:03 to go here in the first quarter. We'll go ahead and take a timeout. We're back with more right after this.
Let's get back to business together. Ameris Bank is committed to providing tools you need to do business today. Contactless payment, remote deposit, e-commerce platforms, and more. We're here to make sure you have what you need to operate in today's climate. Learn more at amerisbank.com/backtobusiness.
For 115 years.
Beachview Event Rentals and Design is a full-service event company
with a resolution to provide clients with innovative inventory, ideas, and customer service. Our carefully curated collection of tents, lighting, linens, furniture, and tableware are sure to bring your vision to life and create a truly memorable event. The Beachview crew makes sure to bring the creativity, fun, and excellent customer service that has been winning us the appreciation and respect of all our clients for 20 years to each project.
Hey.
waterfront dining experience, serving fresh seafood, steaks, and barbecue. Visit our website at skippersfishcamp.com.
You love the game, but you don't love the pain. From the moment an injury sidelines you, turn to the experts at Summit Sports Medicine and Orthopaedic Surgery. Our winning team of physicians and orthopaedic surgeons will design a treatment plan just for you, so you can get back in the game quickly and safely. To play your best, you need to work with the best. Visit sghs.org/summit or call 912-466-7340 to schedule your appointment.
Back here at Richard Hull Sports Center, St. Simons Island, Georgia. Our coverage tonight, webcasting Frederica Academy Knights and the Brantley County Herons. And the first quarter is in the books. Dave Cohen along with Kevin Price. And again, two football teams that are looking to get onto the winning track. Thomas Veal with a touchdown pass to Eli Fritchman, capping a four-play, 32-yard drive. Kevin, that put Frederica Academy up 6-0. They missed the PAT. And then a big play for Brantley County to eventually take that lead.
Yes, the things that kind of stand out to me right now is, number one, the field position that Frederica has had in this ball game. And, of course, they cashed in the first time they had the ball with the touchdown pass to steal that 32-yard drive. But the Brantley defense has stood tall since then with their backs against the wall. And they're really kind of dominating in the trenches. That Brantley County defensive line is winning the battle up front. Brantley started off bad with bad field position, had the special teams mistake, losing that football on the onside kick. But they got the big defensive play, and right now they've got the momentum as we go to quarter number two.
And the snap to Veal, and Veal is going to get run out of bounds just beyond the 40-yard line. Looked like they ran him out at the 41. Get a 7-6 advantage right here for Brantley County. Let's take another look. It was play action as Triplett stays in and blocks. No receivers downfield, so Veal is going to take it on his own and get run out of bounds at about the 41.
Yeah, good coverage in the secondary there, and eventually the pass rush got to him. They flushed him out of the pocket, and he had to try to get some yardage on his own. So, again, good defense there by Brantley County, forcing a punting situation.
Yeah, Frederica Academy going to be forced to punt the football. And that is Fritchman. Back deep on the punt return is number 35, JoJo Steedley. And he will get wrapped up right away. And
taken by Kellen Middleton.
So Frederica Academy's defensive unit will come onto the field right now. They're down by one. Brantley County in the white jerseys tonight. After that pick six, looking to build on a little bit of momentum here.
Yeah, and the biggest problem for this Brantley offense, they graduated a big senior class last year. They do have 16 returning seniors on this roster out of their 50-something players, but they didn't play a whole lot last year, so they're just now getting varsity experience, and they're really just young and thin up front, so these guys are learning on the fly, and that depth and lack of experience has hurt them so far on the offensive front.
First down from the 29-yard line. They're going to try to run the football in behind left tackle. Not a whole lot going on there. On the carry was 45, Gavin King. He's playing in his fourth game of the season. Came in with 21 carries, totaling just under 80 yards.
Second and 11.
And built like a fullback. And so it's going to bring up second down. They'll call it second and 10, ball at the 29-yard line.
Yeah, and Gavin was supposed to be their workhorse back, and he really needs to get lathered up and get going here tonight and give this offense more production. They really need something out of him.
Early second quarter, here's the snap. Taiwan Walker, screen pass out here to the near side, is complete to King, and he'll try to get to the outside, ends up getting tackled.
Josh Meadows.
And that is going to bring up third down here for Brantley County. Nothing
nice
downfield,
there by
swing it out to King.
Nice tackle there by Josh Meadows, one of the leading players and team leaders for Frederica Academy. I think he will have the chance to go off and play college football next year. Good-looking kid there on the Frederica defense.
So just outside the 30-yard line. Here's the snap to Walker. He'll roll out to the far side. He'll throw on the run. It is incomplete. The intended receiver that time was Brian Hyatt. He's playing in his fifth game of the season. Came in with four catches and 47 yards.
Fourth down.
So a three and out, I guess, for the Brantley County Herons here.
Facing a fourth and 11, Brantley County will punt the football, 35. I'll make that Cameron Allen, who averages 33 yards punting the football so far this year. And back deep on the punt return for Frederica. Nice return, although a lot of white jerseys going to drag him down, and that is number 20, Jaden Rose. So Rose with the return. It will bring up first down coming up here for Frederica Academy. They're down a point here, 7-6.
Yeah, and we saw a little bit of extracurricular activity out there, so things might be getting a little chippy as these guys starting to go at it. Again, both of these coaches really like each other, but you know they want their teams to win, and I think these guys really like their coaches and want to win for them. And we do have a flag down over there on the Brantley sideline. So, yeah, as you see, the officials are talking about it. So we might have to redo this punt here if it's on Brantley County. We'll see. Yep. No offsetting penalties here.
Well, there goes face mask and a hold.
Was it an illegal use of hands? Was that it?
So early here in the second quarter, as the officials explaining the what we think will be offsetting penalties.
Definitely taking a little while to sort this out. Coach Derek has his guys huddled up over here. And now a few Brantley coaches going to bring their guys over and talk some strategy as well, and looks like the officials are going to huddle again and get it all straightened out. Should definitely be offsetting penalties. Beautiful night for football, though, Dave, over here on St. Simon's Island as we have flipped the calendar to October. And speaking of October, you can see some pink wristbands and some of the players, you know, wearing pink socks and different things. As you know, October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, so we'll start seeing a lot of those pink different things out there. Some of the cheerleaders had the pink pom-poms. I believe Southeast Georgia Health System around here is a, and some of sports medicine as well, is a big proponent of supporting breast cancer awareness, and they do a great job of supporting the middle school and high school athletics around here in the public schools, and also Frederica Academy, their middle school and high school athletics as well. So they probably donate a lot of the items to these teams. Maybe even see some pink mask around here this year as well, as we all are dealing with COVID-19. And, of course, we're just glad to be playing high school football during this pandemic environment as well.
No question. The officials over talking to head coach, Brantley County head coach, Jeff Cannon, about the penalty situation.
And Dave, I know these guys. I know several of them by name. They're from the local Gold Coast Officials Association. And this may be a little more complicated than I realize, but this is just par for the course. And our producer, TJ, can tell you all about it.
Well, whatever it is, it's a long explanation.
You know, And honestly, I mean, I'm going to tell on myself here because I don't know the rule either. Offsetting penalty, and I think they've changed the rules maybe sometimes too, so I shouldn't pick on the Gold Coast if I don't know the rule either. But sometimes, you know, if it's a 15-yarder, you walk it off one way, and if it's a 10-yarder, you know, you walk it off back, and it's a difference of 5 yards. And then sometimes I think you replay the down. So Brantley, yeah, Brantley's retreating, so we're re-kicking.
The offsetting penalties were a block in the back and a face mask penalty. So they will just replay the punt play. And Cameron Allen, again, who averages about 33 yards per punt, will punt it away again.
And we're going to have another stoppage of play here. And once again, it's another penalty unless somebody called a timeout. Encroachment on the defense.
Offsides on the nine.
So Brantley will get 5 free yards here.
Still fourth down.
Again, back deep for Frederica is Jaden Rose for the Knights. And there's the kick, and it's going to take a bounce inside the 45 to the 40. So it should be pretty good field position at about the 42 or the 43-yard line for Frederica Academy here with 10:20 to go in the second quarter.
Is that another flag on the field?
Flag on the play.
Yes, it is. Illegal shift against Frederica. So Brantley, if it's Brantley could re-kick it because Frederica does have good field position, but at the same time, you open yourself up to a return, and they have not been the best on special teams this year, giving up kick and punt returns for touchdowns.
So play is set to resume here, and they will spot the football. Penalty against Frederica. It'll take him back inside the 30 to about the 27-yard line. So Thomas Veal, the quarterback, out of the shotgun. Here's this low snap, has to really concentrate to pick up the football and get it in the hands of his running back. Triplet on the carry.
Yeah, and I guess.
Luckily they didn't turn the ball over.
No gain on the play.
That's right. I guess that was a design play, and they were lucky to get that handoff off for sure. You're exactly right, Dave. That could have been a very bad situation if they don't get that handoff off and Brantley gets on that football in a good spot on Brantley's on Frederica's side of the field.
Snap coming up here on second down. Again, another low snap. They'll hand it off to Triplett again. He'll run in behind left tackle. And that run good for about 2 yards. And that'll bring up third down here for Frederica Academy.
You know, penalties and these snaps. Yeah, penalties and these bad snaps, execution errors now mounting for Frederica. They're kind of been their own worst enemy here as we go throughout the first half.
Snap on third down again to Triplett. Triplett zigs and zags, and that should be enough for a first down for the Knights. Nice run there by Jordan Triplett, the freshman. Came in again with 20 carries, 2 rushing touchdowns, and 243 rushing yards in their first three ball games. Nice job avoiding the white jerseys. And finally brought down, ran into 35, JoJo Steedley, one of their inside linebackers. Here's a running play to the outside there by Triplett. This time run down from behind by 48, R.J. Bryan, the outside linebacker.
Yeah, I think you can see what Coach Derrick has done. He's gone back to the run game and has put this game right now, or the rest of this half, it looks like, on the shoulders of his offensive front, and has decided to challenge them and see if they can win the line of scrimmage and back this Brantley defense on its heels.
Snap on first down. He'll run to the near side in behind left tackle. And that's going to be good for about 5 yards. Nice job following his blockers over there on the left side. Right behind one of the offensive linemen. Keep an eye on 50 Garrett Squire. Nice job blocking downfield. Triplett stays right behind him.
Is that where you are?
Out of the shotgun, Veal again. They're just going to work the ball to Triplett again. He'll run in behind the left side of his offensive line.
Triplett.
Okay. Also along that offensive line, Will Counts, number 57. So good job there by Triplett.
It also looks like, I believe that is Josh Meadows, they're running behind number 8.
So trailing 7-6, here's the snap to Veal. The pitch is going to go to Triplett. Sidesteps one oncoming defender and then runs into a wall of white jerseys. Saw number 20 in there, Brahiat, for Brantley County.
Yeah, so if you're just tuning in, Kyle Perez on the sideline in a walking boot. So that puts the pressure, as far as the run game goes, on the freshman Triplett. And he comes in averaging over 12 yards a carry, so he's definitely a good-looking back in that uniform for Frederica. And right now, he's definitely carrying the mail for the Knights on this drive.
So the drive continues, a one-point lead for Brantley County. 6:45 to play here in the second quarter. Throwing on the run, it's going to be incomplete on the pass play. The intended receiver that time, you saw number 20, Jaden Rose Scally, the senior.
Fourth down.
Yeah, and this drive started at the 27 with 10:20 to go in the quarter, so it's already approaching 4 minutes. By far the longest drive by either team here in the first half.
It'll bring up fourth down here for the Frederica Knights, and that'll bring on the punter, Eli Fritchman. Came into the game having punted the football 8 times, averaging 31 yards per kick. And back deep for Brantley County should be 35, JoJo Steedley. Ball's going to take a bounce in favor of Frederica. And boy, once again, a tough position, field position-wise, coming up for Brantley County. Midway through the second quarter here at St. Simon's Island, and Brantley County Herons holding on to a one-point lead over Frederica Academy. It's 7-6. We're back with more coverage on our webcast tonight right after this.
Let's get back to business together. Ameris Bank is committed to providing tools you need to do business today. Contactless payment, remote deposit, e-commerce platforms, and more. We're here to make sure you have what you need to operate in today's climate. Learn more at amerisbank.com/backtobusiness.
Golden Isles for 115 years.
Beachview Event Rentals and Design is a full-service event company
with a resolution to provide clients with innovative inventory, ideas, and customer service. Our carefully curated collection of tents, lighting, linens, furniture, and tableware are sure to bring your vision to life and create a truly memorable event. The Beachview crew makes sure to bring the creativity, fun, and excellent customer service that has been winning us the appreciation and respect of all our clients for 20 years to each project.
Darien's Fun Waterfront Dining Experience, serving fresh seafood, steaks, and barbecue. This is visit our website at skippersfishcamp.com.
You love the game, but you don't love the pain. From the moment an injury sidelines you, turn to the experts at Summit Sports Medicine and Orthopaedic Surgery. Our winning team of physicians and orthopaedic surgeons will design a treatment plan just for you, so you can get back in the game quickly and safely. To play your best, you need to work with the best. Visit sghs.org/summit or call 912-466-7340 to schedule your appointment.
Back here at Richard Hull Sports Center in St. Simons Island, midway through the second quarter. Again, tough field position, Kevin, for Brantley County. And good defensive pressure here by Frederica Academy, although the Knights trailing it right now by a point, 7-6.
Yeah, they ran the ball for no gain on first down and incompletion on second down. And then Frederica loaded up and brought the pressure on third down. And Tywan Walker threw an ill-advised pass right in the teeth of the defense. He threw it up as basically a prayer, and he was lucky that ball did not get intercepted. And Brantley County now set to punt the ball from the back of their own end zone. Frederica should get the ball right here, obviously deep in Brantley territory. And it's going to get blocked in the end zone.
Blocked in the end zone and recovered in the end zone. On the recovery,
that's a safety.
Chase Schuneman.
Out of the back of the end zone.
Big play by Frederica Academy. Pressure from all sides and right up the middle, not allowing Cameron Allen room to punt the football, and it's recovered in the end zone.
Yes, well, they were definitely going to get good field position, but instead they're going to get the safety and also get the ball back. So this could be a big end of the first half for the Knights.
There you see Schuneman, number two, with the pressure right up the middle, right in there on the punter, Cameron Allen. So tacked on two with the safety. And Frederica Academy will take a one-point lead at 8-7, and as you mentioned, also get the football.
What shot you want me on, TJ?
He just came right off the edge, just kept on charging. We'll see it again. You see him coming here off the left side. Basically goes unblocked right there, and then the other guy has to come in and pick him up. And I believe it was
Cameron
actually number
Allen.
Eight, though.
Was it? Cameron Allen will kick it away. And it's returned by Frederica Academy. And, of course, who else would it be? But number four, Jordan Triplett on the return. And Frederica Academy should have really a better than average field position here. And now sitting on a one-point lead at 8-7. A little over 5 minutes to go here in the second quarter.
I think Schuneman number two came away with the ball as he was coming off the edge, but I believe it may have been number eight, Meadows, that actually blocked the kick.
So first down for the Knights just inside the 40. It'll be a run play right up the middle. Jordan Triplett, the freshman. Good for 2 to 3 yards in the carry. It'll bring up second down here for the Knights.
Well, this Brantley defense has been put in some tough positions here in this first half, and they're in a tough one here again, so they need to definitely bow their necks here and see if they can keep this game at 8-7 going into the half, and the Herons will just have to feel good about it. So we'll see what the Knights can do here. This could be a big possession for Frederica to take all the momentum into the locker room.
Second down from the 41. Man in motion here to the near side. Ball hit the field. We got a flag thrown at the same time.
Coachman on the Brantley defense.
Flag on the play.
So 5 yards in the direction for Frederica Academy.
Brings up second and two.
Brantley's been firing off that ball really fast in the first half. That time they just got a little too quick.
So Veal comes in out of the shotgun. And they're going to hand it off. Triplett Broke through the middle, cuts now to the right, and is finally dragged down. Trying to get the number of the Brantley County player on the tackle. Might have been 27, the defensive back Lance Ruiz. First down run there by Triplett. And Frederica Academy threatening here as we begin to get late in the second quarter. Nice job avoiding the first two oncoming tacklers. And then you see finally dragged down as he tried to get to the outside.
It was Ruiz on the tackle.
Snap again. They'll hand it off to Triplett. Sidesteps. And still on his feet. A lot of white jerseys having to get involved to make the tackle. In on the tackle was the linebacker Cameron Allen, 44.
Gain of five, second.
It'll be interesting to follow this Triplett kid the next 3 years. He's got a good looking body on him, got some good size, got a little bit of shake and bake, and I just think he's going to get bigger, stronger, and maybe a little bit faster. He's going to be a good hard nosed runner for Frederica over the course of his career, it looks like.
Snap to Veal, hand it off Triplett. Triplett going to try to run it in behind left tackle. And he is brought down there. First in on the tackle there, 48. R.J. Bryan, the linebacker. He's a junior for Brantley County.
Bryan Ratliff.
What I like about him is he looks like he's got pretty decent vision, particularly for a young kid, but he doesn't take long to get north and south, and he gets behind his pads, runs at a good pad level. He reminds me a little bit of a guy named James Dean that Coach Brandon Derrick would be very familiar with. He coached him at Glenn Academy, and James Dean went on to play tight end, fullback, maybe an H-back type at Georgia Southern.
Triplett tail of the eye. Now they're going to give him a football and a underhand toss. Not quite a toss sweep. Triplett, though, trying to get out to the outside here on the near side.
On the tackle for a loss.
And he
is tripped up. That was Ruiz again on the tackle.
Fourth and two.
2:30 to go. I believe Coach Brandon Derrick still has two timeouts in his pocket, so Frederica not necessarily in a hurry here. They're going to milk this clock down and try to punch it in here, using all the time on the clock to expand this lead right before the half.
Again, Frederica Academy coming in at 1-2 on the year in their first three games. And it looks like we have a timeout called. Frederica opened up the season, as Kevin said in our open, with a win in Hayhira, Georgia, beating the Valwood School. And since then, they've dropped their last two to Calvary Day and to Tift area. So playing tonight their fourth game of the season. This is the fifth game of the year for Brantley County.
Mosquito Authority and Pest Authority.
Yeah, and you know, that first game really surprised me. Not so much that Frederica won, you know, but they went over to Hayhira, which is really Valdosta. And, you know, they've kind of developed a rivalry with Valwood. And, you know, Frederica had some problems with the COVID. I'm not so sure that it was kids necessarily having COVID, but kids being exposed to people with COVID, contact tracing and all that kind of stuff. So Frederica sat out for 2 weeks and then really only had a week to get ready for that ball game and sort of went into hurry-up mode. And they're used to hurry-up mode. Obviously, they don't huddle and they get after it on offense. They went over there and pounded Valwood, a good football team, 36-13. And then, you know, Calvary Day School is a big private school in Savannah. They were 7-7 with them at the half, and then that game got away from them, 27-7. They lost. And then last week, they pretty much led the whole way against Tift area and then ended up losing 21-18.
All right, just inside the 20, screen pass here to the near side, and a football is fumbled as Frederica Academy was about to get into the end zone. It was a pass that was caught out in the wind by Bryce Riley. And Riley could not hold on to the football as he was trying to dive towards the end zone, Kevin.
Yep, he was juggling it, trying to reach for the end zone. He should probably just go down, and the Knights should live to play another play as we watch the end zone here. He really never, well, he did have control of it right there. And lost it right there. Number 7 may have punched it out of there. That's a good defensive play there by Quentin Walker. And you'll see it roll right out of the sideline here. This is good camera work by iMint Media. And Brantley gets a huge break right there. Man, what a break for the Herons.
But they're knocking on the door again. Again, Veal out of the shotgun. They got a wide out here to make that Walker going to throw, and it is up, and it's deflected, almost picked off by Frederica Academy. They turned it over on downs, and so it was a break there, as you mentioned, for Brantley County. And Walker not wasting any time to throw that ball downfield here to the near sideline.
Yeah, and you know, I'm a little bit surprised by this. You know, I think Brantley should really just maybe try to get a first down and get out of here and go to the locker room. But, you know, I guess Coach Cannon, kind of borrowing some plays from Coach Derek's playbook, going to be aggressive here. But I'm not so sure about really trying to get aggressive here. I'm just trying to get to halftime, I think, if I'm Brantley, and count my blessings.
Second down and 10, a minute 45 to go, second quarter. Shotgun snap. Walker going to escape the pocket. He's going to throw on the run, and it will be downfield. The pass is incomplete, and it was Kellen Middleton, the intended receiver, down the far sideline.
Eli Frenchman with the coverage.
Now, I will say this. If I'm going to throw the football, that's what I'm going to do, because then basically if it gets picked off, it's more or less like a punt, and then you make Frederica turn around and drive the length of the field on you. But the problem now is you got 1:24 on the clock, and I think Frederica does have one timeout in their pocket. So now you're looking at a situation where, regardless of what you do here, you may have to punt the football away again. And you know, they're not very good on special teams, so it looks like. And, you know, you could be in danger of getting a punt blocked or something like that, or getting a punt returned on you. So we're not through here in this first half just yet. It may not be 8-7 when we go to the locker room.
Snap coming up here to Walker on third down. Again, a minute and 34 to go. He's going to throw on the run, going to try to punch that football in there. The intended receiver.
Intended for Benji O'Neill,
13. That pass is incomplete.
Fourth down, Herons.
And that'll bring up fourth down. So Cameron Allen, 44, is on to punt the football.
Yeah, so let's see what Frederica does here. Do they come after the punt? I would just imagine they would, and see if they can block it, or do they set up a return? Watch number 11 here coming off the edge.
Quick snap, quick kick there by Allen. And that ball is caught by Frederica. And it was returned briefly there by Jaden Rose Scally. Not a whole lot of return yards, but again, still much better than average field position, which it seems like that's been the story all night for the Knights.
Right, like I say, yeah, that has been the story all night. 1:23 to go in the half. I think they have one timeout left, if I'm not mistaken, and 1:23 to work with. And we'll see if Brantley County can make one last defensive stand and keep this an 8-7 ball game.
Snap to Veal. He's got all the time in the world. Now he'll get chased out of the pocket. Going to run down the far sideline. Still got room, and he will run out of bounds just beyond the Brantley County sideline.
Flag down on the field, Dave, right in the middle of the line of scrimmage. I would think that's in the neighborhood of a hole, but we will check the marker.
Flag on the play.
So if it's a hold, it'll bring the play back, which is tough for Frederica Academy. That was a nice run there by Veal.
Yeah, again, good coverage downfield by that Brantley secondary. They flush him out of the pocket, and he runs for yardage. So good coverage there. By the Brantley secondary to force Veal to tuck that football and run and try to make something out of nothing. Yeah, you can see the hole right there. The defensive lineman got twisted around. I guess they're going to get the hold on 64 for Frederica. Won't call his name, won't embarrass the kid.
So snap again, and it's going to be a pass over to the near sideline in the flat, incomplete. And the intended receiver that time again was
intended for Jaden
Rose Scally.
Now here I am again. I'm not calling the ball game as the offensive coordinator, but I'm running the football and I'm punting and I'm getting out of here.
Second down.
Both of these teams are probably fortunate to be where they are. Of course, Frederica really should have scored on that last possession to open up this lead here. And that was an unfortunate break for them and a really good break for Brantley County.
So late here in the second quarter, as these two teams about to head to the locker room, an 8-7 lead for Frederica Academy. Man in motion here to the near side is Scally. Going to quick pass over here to the near side. It is caught on the reception. It is number 11, Bryce Riley. Pass is complete. Nice job trying to follow his blocker there, Fritchman, and he ends up in the air. Good job holding on to the football, hitting the ground hard.
Yeah, I was about to say, Riley looks a little bit shaken up there.
Inside of a minute to go here in the second quarter in the first half.
Definitely has been an entertaining ball game. Coach Derrick looking at his cell phone and arguing at the referees. That's pretty typical. I can tell you he does not like the Gold Coast Officials Association. He probably doesn't mind me saying that.
Flag goes against the Knights. Still second down.
So that'll back the football up just outside the 35-yard line for the Knights near hash. They check the play. Veal out of the shotgun. Triplet lines up just to his left. And there's the snap. He's going to step up in the pocket. Pressure and... Not sure
his arm must have been going forward.
Yeah, I was going to say incomplete.
Pass is incomplete.
Sorry, I'll throw the ball.
Will Mason with the pressure.
I guess somebody whistled incomplete. I didn't really see it, but surely somebody did.
Third down.
So they'll put it at the 37-yard line. 34.7 seconds to go. Triplet lines up in the backfield to Veal's right. And they're going to. That was going to be a handoff. And we got whistles again. Encroachment again, Kevin.
Yeah, and that was probably on number 33, little Michael Connor, coming off the edge right there. We may see that on the replay. This Brantley defensive front is really firing off the football. You can see him coming off the right end right here. They're really firing off that football really quick tonight. I don't know if they're timing the snap count or what, but that's about the second or third encroachment penalty. You can see him coming off the edge right there. That had to be on him.
Jordan Triplett.
So Frederica Academy will keep it on the ground. A run play right back up the middle. Knights. Triplet again on the carry. And this is going to take us right to the end of the second quarter.
Well, yeah, I thought that was going to be the final snap. Frederica was trying to get one more playoff, and they think they did. And I thought it looks like the officials may have gone to sleep. And Coach Derrick, of course, is irate. And I'm not sure if they got that snap off or not. And here we go, controversy to end the first half.
So
and
the clock
we're going to get a
zeros.
False start.
Yeah. So that'll be the end of the first half here in St. Simon's Island. And it is Frederica Academy headed to the locker room with a one-point lead over Brantley County, 8-7. Our halftime show comes your way next.
You're nice.
After this timeout.
Let's get back to business together. Amerisbank is committed to providing tools you need to do business today. Contactless payment, remote deposit, e-commerce platforms, and more. We're here to make sure you have what you need to operate in today's climate. Learn more at amerisbank.com/backtobusiness.
Serving the Golden Isles for 115 years.
Beachview Event Rentals and Design is a full-service event company
with a resolution to provide clients with innovative inventory, ideas, and customer service. Our carefully curated collection of tents, lighting, linens, furniture, and tableware are sure to bring your vision to life and create a truly memorable event. The Beachview crew makes sure to bring the creativity, fun, and excellent customer service that has been winning us the appreciation and respect of all our clients for 20 years to each project.
Darien's Fun Waterfront Dining Experience, serving fresh seafood, steaks, and barbecue. Visit our website at skippersfishcamp.com.
You love the game, but you don't love the pain. From the moment an injury sidelines you, turn to the experts at Summit Sports Medicine and Orthopaedic Surgery. Our winning team of physicians and orthopaedic surgeons will design a treatment plan just for you, so you can get back in the game quickly and safely. To play your best, you need to work with the best. Visit sghs.org/summit or call 912-466-7340 to schedule your appointment.
Halftime here in St. Simon's Island, Richard Hull Sports Center, Frederica Academy, Brantley County tonight on our weekly webcast. And right now it's low scoring, it's exciting. Frederica Academy on the backs of a safety in the second quarter. They take a 1-point lead into the locker room. Tonight's game is sponsored by Summit Sports Medicine and Orthopedic Surgery. Also by Ameris Bank, Skipper's Fish Camp, Lang Building Supply, and Beachview Event Rentals and Design. Dave Cohen along with Kevin Price to talk about that first half. And it was everything we thought that it might be. And then some, you know, plays out of the ordinary. It seemed like, as we mentioned, that Frederica Academy had really good field position throughout the entire first half. They have the 1-point lead. And we also had that situation with Riley fumbling the football that could have very well been another six. The lead right now could be 14-7. Instead, they're up by one.
Yeah, Frederica really could be out in front by, of course, a bigger margin than this. Field position for them has been in their favor throughout the ball game. Brantley County definitely has to feel fortunate to only be down by this 1-point margin here in this ball game at this point at the half. Once again, Brantley County's offense is continuing to struggle. They've only scored 13 points in their four ball games. They're an 0-4 football team, and that's the biggest reason why. And, you know, once again here tonight, they've yet to punt in a touchdown in the first 24 minutes.
Jordan Triplett, the workhorse so far tonight for Frederica Academy. And right now, let's take a look at some of our highlights in that first half, Kevin. Right out of the gate for Frederica Academy, they're going to put the football up in the air, and it is going to be caught by Eli Fritchman. And right out of the gate, Kevin, a big play. And then we see Triplett again. Just one of his many spectacular runs in that first half.
Yeah, that first touchdown pass was actually on fourth down. And like you said, Triplett, a good-looking back, a workhorse back. And I really think he's got a bright future ahead of him. He's just a freshman at Frederica, so keep an eye on him. He's going to be a player to watch in the future.
And this was the big play for Brantley County. It was a pick six. At 75 yards later, at that point, they had tied the football game and were about to take a 1-point lead.
Yeah, Frederica was having some aggressive play calling early on, throwing a ball a lot more than they had early in the season, and that was a good play by the Brantley defense, one of their big playmakers on the defensive side of the football, playing center field back there, makes the pick six, and goes right down the sideline for the 7 points. That gave Brantley County the brief lead right there at 7-6 before Frederica had the safety.
And the safety tacks on two, and that's where we are as we get ready for second half action tonight from Richard Hell Sports Center in St. Simons Island. Frederica Academy 8, Brantley County 7. More football coming up right after this.
Let's get back to business together. Ameris Bank is committed to providing tools you need to do business today. Contactless payment, remote deposit, e-commerce platforms, and more. We're here to make sure you have what you need to operate in today's climate. Learn more at amerisbank.com/backtobusiness.
Golden Owls for 115 years.
Beachview Event Rentals and Design is a full-service event company with a resolution to provide clients with innovative inventory, ideas, and customer service. Our carefully curated collection of tents, lighting, linens, furniture, and tableware are sure to bring your vision to life and create a truly memorable event. The Beachview crew makes sure to bring the creativity, fun, and excellent customer service that has been winning us the appreciation and respect of all our clients for 20 years to each project.
Darien's Fun Waterfront Dining Experience, serving fresh seafood, steaks, and barbecue. Visit our website at skippersfishcamp.com.
You love the game, but you don't love the pain. From the moment an injury sidelines you, turn to the experts at Summit Sports Medicine and Orthopaedic Surgery. Our winning team of physicians and orthopaedic surgeons will design a treatment plan just for you, so you can get back in the game quickly and safely. To play your best, you need to work with the best. Visit sghs.org/summit or call 912-466-7340 to schedule your appointment.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, we need everyone to clear the field. Please clear the field. The teams are about to come back.
Okay, I'm here.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I'm ready anytime.
Dave Cohen and Kevin Price back here bringing you live coverage tonight from Richard Hull Sports Center in St. Simons Island. And there you see the score. Frederica Academy holding on to a one-point lead, 8-7 over Brantley County. Again, tonight's broadcast is sponsored by Summit Sports Medicine and Orthopaedic Surgery, by Ameris Bank, Skipper's Fish Camp, Lang Building Supply, and Beachview Event Rentals and Design. And Kevin, seen some big plays tonight. Probably no play bigger than the pick six there by R.J. Bryan. At the time there in the first quarter put Brantley County in what was their first and still only lead.
Yeah, that's right. That definitely gave Brantley County a boost, gave them some confidence, gave them that 7-6 lead at the time. They've had trouble scoring points offensively all year long, have been shut out twice in their first four games, have only scored 13 points all year. So when you can't score on offense, you get some points with your defense or on special teams, and that gave them that 7-6 lead. But also, Dave, as you know, the other big play in the ball game, you could argue which one was bigger, but that punch out by number 7 for the Brantley defense, Quentin Walker, to get that ball out of the receiver's hands right there late in the half after the safety to keep Frederica from punching another touchdown in and increasing this 8-7 lead was also very big, as he keeps Brantley from giving up a touchdown to allow Brantley to go up even bigger in this game. And, without that, I'm not sure that Brantley can score enough to get out of here with a victory on St. Simons Island. So they're still in this game at the half.
You're exactly right, Kevin. The biggest play for Brantley might be the Quentin Walker forced fumble, because you're right, as much as they have had trouble scoring, if they were to get down, 14-7, the way the offense has struggled, who knows if that could be too much to overcome. Second half is underway, and Brantley County kicking off, and it will sail out of the back of the end zone. They'll bring the ball out, and that's where Frederica Academy Knights will start their first possession with a one-point lead here in quarter number 3.
And also, we were just informed that Brandon Derrick, I don't know, I think you may have saw him talking to the officials there as we were getting ready for kickoff. You know, right before the half, he thought Frederica got off one more snap before the game clock went to 0. He was just penalized coming out of the half for unsportsmanlike conduct. That is why Brantley County was also able to kick it through the end zone. But nonetheless, Frederica starts at his 20.
And they're going to keep the ball on the ground. Triplett, big hole up the middle. is going to pick up the first down plus some before he is finally dragged down. The tackle there, 20, Brian Hyatt, the junior inside linebacker. And an impressive run there, Kevin, by Triplett again. We've called his name a lot in the first half.
Yeah, I think this is great play calling right here. We'll see if they put this drive on their offensive line and Triplett and try to hammer this ball right at this Brantley defense to start this second half. They were ending the first half this way and had a really impressive drive going right there before bogging down in Brantley territory.
Second play in behind left tackle. It'll bring up second down here for the Knights. And they have come out on two plays and run the ball with some authority as they hold on to that one-point lead early here in the third quarter. Veal out of the shotgun again. Triplett lines up behind him. It's going to be a quick throw. Screen pass over here to the near side. And it is complete to Eli Fritzman. He was on the receiving end of that touchdown pass early in the first quarter that put Frederica up 6-0. And right now they're moving the ball with some authority right now. Quick catch on his knees, and he's able to hold on.
Probably right back to the run here.
They'll hand it off to Triplett. He's got some room, trying to get to the outside, dragged down. And that might have been a touchdown saving tackle there by 27, Lance Lewis, the senior defensive back.
Yeah, I think you're right.
A lot of speed as he gets to the outside. Grabbed him around the waist and wrestled him to the grass here at the near hash. Quick throw again out to the flat. Caught by Eli Fritzman. He'll turn upfield. Yards after the catch. Good for about three or four more yards by Fritzman. And again, a very impressive drive, Kevin, so far for the guys from Frederica Academy.
I won't be surprised at all if Coach Derrick goes right back to number four Triplett. And also, don't be surprised if they send Josh Meadows in motion again and they run behind him, number eight. He had a big block on that previous down. They're actually going to run it behind Meadows on the right side. And look at Triplett. They're lathering the young buck up, and he's doing some damage going north and south. Like I said, in that first half on that drive they had going late in the half, he reminded me of a former Glenn Academy running back named James Dean. Coach Derrick was the play caller for that offense. And I like this young guy for Frederica. I'm going to keep my eye on him over the next 4 years. He is a guy that can carry the ball 30 to 35 times a game. I think he just gets stronger and stronger as the game goes. Is Brantley County calling the timeout here? They might be gassed.
Timeout call, but we'll get another look at Triplett cutting back to the middle of the field. And that'll lead us to our first timeout. We've got an injured player, it looks like, down in the field. Frederica Academy here in the third quarter. They're threatening with a one-point lead, 8-7 here over Brantley County. We're back with more right after this.
Let's get back to business together. Ameris Bank is committed to providing tools you need to do business today. Contactless payment, remote deposit, e-commerce platforms, and more. We're here to make sure you have what you need to operate in today's climate. Learn more at amerisbank.com/backtobusiness.
Golden Owls for 115 years.
Beachview Event Rentals and Design is a full-service event company with a resolution to provide clients with innovative inventory, ideas, and customer service. Our carefully curated collection of tents, lighting, linens, furniture, and tableware are sure to bring your vision to life and create a truly memorable event. The Beachview crew makes sure to bring the creativity, fun, and excellent customer service that has been winning us the appreciation and respect of all our clients for 20 years to each project.
Darien's Fun Waterfront Dining Experience, serving fresh seafood, steaks, and barbecue. Visit our website at skippersfishcamp.com.
love the game, but you don't love the pain. From the moment an injury sidelines you, turn to the experts at Summit Sports Medicine and Orthopaedic Surgery. Our winning team of physicians and orthopaedic surgeons will design a treatment plan just for you, so you can get back in the game quickly and safely. To play your best, you need to work with the best. Visit sghs.org/summit or call 912-466-7340 to schedule your appointment.
.9:25 to go here in the third quarter. While we were away on break, they hand that football off again, Kevin, to Jordan Triplett, and he takes it to the house.
Yes, they do. He was going to go off the hole between right guard and right tackle. Josh Meadows was going to lead him through the hole once again, but then he got a big block as he sprung it outside. And the big block out there was by number 20 for the Frederica Academy Knights, Jaden Rose Scally. And I tell you what, I'm just really impressed by this young buck, the freshman Triplett. He bounces it outside, good vision as he goes through the hole. And once he got that block by Scally and got another block again on the outside, so good perimeter blocking there by the Knights. A good opening drive as they go 80 yards and open up a 14-7 lead here to start the third quarter.
The PAT was no good. That's why it's a 14-7 ball game. Fritchman with the kickoff. And we'll see if Brantley County can get anything going. Good coverage downfield there by Jaden Rose Scally on the kick coverage team. And here comes Brantley County, Kevin.
Dave, here's your scoring drive. 7 plays, 80 yards, 24 run by Triplett.
So an impressive drive, mostly on the back of their freshman running back. And here's Brantley County, going to hand a football off. And a great job on the pursuit and the tackle there. You saw right in there was 33, Jacob Aiken, the linebacker, running down the ball carrier. And a big-time tackle there by Aiken.
Yeah, good pursuit as he just chased him down the line of scrimmage. Possibly could have been a horse collar tackle, but I think it was clean.
So it'll bring up second down. We take another look. It was Middleton on the carry, and he was not able to get to the outside, which was the initial goal. And so second down coming up here for Brantley County. 8:40 to go on the clock here, third quarter. Snap coming up on second down. Middleton in motion. And there's movement along the line. There's going to be a penalty flag thrown, and I believe it'll be against Frederica Academy.
Yeah, Frederica County pointing like it should be. Or Brantley County pointing like it should be encroachment on Frederica, and it is.
Offsides on the Knights. That'll make it second
down. So that
five.
Will help, should make it second down and manageable here.
So movement on that front defensive three, and it will bring up second down. Middleton again goes in motion. Snap, Walker. Walker play action. Fake on a handoff. He's going to dump it off over here near side. It is caught. Middleton makes his way over to this side of the field. He'll make the catch, and he gets run out of bounds over in front of the Frederica Academy sideline.
So it looks like Brantley County has made a decision here to maybe work the edges, whether it's in the run game or the pass game. Of course, I know they've only run a couple of plays here. And I kind of think maybe what they maybe need to do is get Walker more active in the offense at quarterback, roll him out, let him make some plays with his legs or his arm, and here he goes running the football here straight ahead. Good push there on the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, from the 30-yard line. You called it. Great run right up the middle there by Walker. And good for a first down for Brantley County.
Gain of 7, second and 3.
Dave at the
far
half.
Side is...
Go ahead.
Go ahead. Out of the shotgun is Walker. Wideouts to both sides. They seem comfortable to go to the air. Pressure up the middle. Walker is going to get brought down did not have time to release the football. He had wideouts, three wide, two to the near side, one to the far side. The pressure up the middle from Frederica Academy. And you talked about him a little while ago, 56, Elijah Harris, I think, pressure up the middle.
Third down, Harris.
Yeah, somebody missed a block there in the interior line, or actually he just goes around big number 77 there. Cam Van Arsdale. And has a beeline to the quarterback there, so Brantley now behind the chains.
Correction, that 56 was Will Thompson. Here's shotgun snap, going to roll out. Walker's going to throw the football.
Walker's pass incomplete.
Incomplete. Again, Kellum Middleton is the intended receiver.
But I would imagine, that, Leo,
Kevin, if you're Frederica Academy, you know Middleton is going to be the number one, you know, option for Walker.
Right, no doubt about it. Comes in as their all-purpose yardage leader, mostly as a pass catcher, but he does run the football as well. But before that lost yardage play, at the half, Brantley only had 5 yards of offense.
So on fourth down, Cameron Allen will punt the football. Just gets it away. Good pressure up the middle there by Frederica Academy. And it will be fielded. And Jalen Scally-Rose
will return to the 32. Knights will take over
on the return. And a 14-7 score now in favor of Frederica Academy. They've got the football. And, you know, that's why I thought, Kevin, that last drive for Brantley County was so important, because the way Triplett was running with authority, if they come back and score another touchdown, a 2-score deficit might be too much to overcome.
Yeah, for sure. And the rest of this game right now is going to rest in terms of Brantley County on their defense. They got to keep this game within a 1-score game. They can't let it get away from them because their offense has trouble scoring points.
And sure enough, Triplett gets the ball, and he'll run right in behind the center and left guard, basically running right in behind Garrett Squire along that offensive line.
No gain on the play.
And, you know, Dave, to be honest with you, the defense is going to have to help them out. Either they're going to have to keep them in a short field situation if they can, possibly with a turnover, or they may just have to score again themselves.
Yeah, with Triplett running the ball as well as he has, you know, the other factor, too, is keeping an eye on the clock if he's able to bust loose again, because as long as they keep it on the ground and that clock keeps running, as you said, eventually the Brantley County defense is going to have to try to come up with a big play. They got to try to get that ball back.
Right. We're already inside the halfway mark of the third quarter, so we got a little bit less than 18 minutes to go. And if Frederica were to just get one more score, regardless of if it's a field goal or for sure a touchdown, you can sure bet that Brandon Derry is going to keep that ball on the ground the rest of the way in this football game and eat that clock up, knowing that Brantley has trouble scoring points.
So 5.5 to go. This is going to be a pass play. Veal is going to look to the near sideline, and he's got a man. It's caught, and it's going to be a touchdown. Almost a touchdown. Jaden Scally-Rose running as fast as he possibly can. Really nice job by the DB there for Brantley County. We'll try to get his number. That's number 7, Quentin Walker, who made that big play on Riley in the first half. He saves another touchdown, Kevin.
Yeah, and what you do is you lull them to sleep with that run game. And we did say in the pregame that Coach Derrick called the first couple of ball games real conservative, letting Bill kind of settle back into that quarterback spot. But we thought he would take some vertical shots down the field, as Bill looked pretty good at quarterback in the third ball game. And there he goes with the home run ball there. And you're right, Quentin Walker saves another touchdown, at least for now, for the Herons. But Brantley County, as Larry Munson used to say, Frederica down there knocking on that door once again.
And that's exactly what they're doing. Football inside the 5-yard line. And again, another big play defensively there by Quentin Walker.
And we get a personal foul, horse collar tackle, I believe, was the initial indication. So that will move, or should move, the home team, Frederica, a little bit closer to that goal line. Want to spot it just outside the 5, Dave, it looks like.
Yep, and you know who's going to get that football. You see Yeah. Triplet, and ball hit the ground, I believe, and then Triplet was able to pick it up. A correction, that ended up being football staying in the hands of Thomas Veal, and they're fortunate they didn't turn it over.
Yep, they've had a couple of low snaps. That's been an issue. I'm sure Coach Derek has got that notepad out, and he's writing that down. Three or four of those, and you're right, they were lucky not to lose it there and blow another scoring opportunity.
Second and goal.
So it'll ring up second and goal. Looks like the football is at the three-yard line for Frederica Academy. And again, Triplett will line up behind Veal. So just inside the five, they're going to hand the football off, and Triplett is going to run in behind left tackle, 3 yards out into the end zone, and that is a Frederica Academy Knights touchdown, and they now go up by a 20-7 score.
Yeah, they were going to run right behind Meadows again as he goes in motion. I think the guy he was intended to block may have got around Meadows there, but Josh Triplett does it basically on his own. They weren't going to tackle him. His second touchdown of the ball game, and the young freshman is headed to MVP honors for Frederica here in this ball game. And I hate to say it for Brantley County's case, but that may just about wrap it up because they have only scored 20 points all season, counting the seven they have here tonight.
So the point after is up, and it is good by the place kicker, Colin Vinhatero. And it's a 21-7 advantage now in favor of Frederica Academy. And Triplett has really just been too much so far tonight for the defensive unit of Brantley County to slow down.
Yes, he has. Just a, I guess I can't say it enough. Just a really good high school football player as a young ninth grader. They do have a middle school team at Frederica, but not a JV team. And you see him kind of doing that little let's eat. And he's certainly eating this Brantley County Heron defense up here tonight as we're 2.5 quarters through this football game. His second touchdown of the night. And he has to have surpassed that 100-yard mark I would mention against.
I would think so. And Fritchman getting set. He'll kick it away to Brantley County. At 4.5 minutes to go here in quarter number three tonight here at Richard Hull Sports Center. And as we talked about in our pregame, Frederica trying to get to 2-2 on the year. And for Brantley County, they're trying to notch that first win of the season. That's going to be a short kick. And it's going to be recovered by Brantley County on the recovery. On the recovery team, it was Little Michael Connor, the sophomore. He tries to get to the near side, ends up getting tackled there, and it's Chase Schuneman on special teams on the kicking unit there to make the tackle.
Yeah, and you know, I kind of feel sorry for Brantley County because their schedule's not going to get easier. They've actually played some really good teams already. Charlton County, Southeast Bullock, Jeff Davis, and Bacon. Those teams are a combined 10-3, but they're staring down the barrel at some good teams in their region, most notably Pierce County, which is undefeated in AAA, and also Applin County. Those are two really, really good football teams, so the wins may be few and far between for this young and inexperienced Brantley County team.
Benji O'Neill goes in motion. They'll throw the football. Picked off, intercepted. Going to be a pick six coming up for Frederica Academy. And let's get the number on the pick six there. It was number six, and that's Blake Holloway, the defensive back. He's a freshman. Second pick six of the night. We've seen in the ball game. This one's going to make the way of Frederica Academy. And they now take a 27-7 lead here in the third quarter, Kevin.
Blake the Snake.
Yeah, and unfortunately, the Brantley County bus driver can probably start cranking up the bus and getting that thing AC'd up and getting ready to go back to Caney Bay, because I think this one might be over at 27-7. And, you know, when it rains, it pours. When you're 0-4 and need something good to happen, you turn back and give the ball right back to the other guys, and they score again. Defensive touchdown. Brantley County has had troubles, all kinds of troubles this year. That's the fifth interception of the season for Taiwan Walker. He threw two pick sixes in the game against Jeff Davis a few weeks ago, and their defense played really well in that game against the Jeff Davis team. It's a hard-nosed physical football team. That is the only time that Jeff Davis scored in that game were on those pick sixes, and Brantley lost 14-6 because, again, they cannot score on offense.
Another look at the pick six, the pass intended for Benji O'Neill, the senior. Ball was deflected into the air, picked off. Holloway down the far sideline takes it all the way to the end zone. And Colin Vinatero is good on the point after attempt. And Frederica Academy increases that lead.
Dave, can you say that name
again?
Can you say that name 10 times in a row fast?
You talking about the place kicker?
Yeah.
Yeah, Colin Vinatero, 28-7 our score. In Frederica Academy, they're going to look to move to 2-2 on the year. Brantley County on the kick return. Nice return on the play there by the Herons.
Kellen Middleton.
Back deep for Brantley County on that return was Middleton. And we'll see what kind of field position they get. I mean, right now they can't play around. They can't really afford, Kevin, to run the football because that keeps the clock running. We're just over 4 minutes to go. They're going to be forced more often than not for Taiwan Walker to put that ball in the air, and we've seen how dangerous that has been so far in this game.
Yeah, if they want to win, they are going to have to go to the air assault. They're down 3 scores, and they have a little over 16 minutes to go in the ball game.
Snap coming up to Walker here on first down. That's Middleton in motion. They're going to fake the handoff, and Walker on the keeper is maybe going to get a yard.
Tackled by John Phillips,
fires. And then on the turn side of that, you pretty well think that FA is going to keep that ball on the ground with triplets.
Loss of 2, 2nd and 12.
And chew that clock up.
John Phillips spires on the tackle there for Frederica Academy on that keeper by Taiwan Walker. Gavin King now lines up in the backfield just to Walker's right. And the snap coming up here on second down. Left to right across your screen. Brantley County, here's the snap. Walker on the keeper, dragging 2 and 3 green jerseys with him. We'll see if he got enough for the first down.
And I'm really surprised that Gavin King so far in this ball game and really the whole season for the Herons has not been more productive. I thought he was supposed to be the bell cow for this offense, and if they're going to win any football games at all, they've got to find a way to get him going.
Third down, let's hear for the Knights.
First 3 games, he had 21 carries and 79 yards. I think he's only carried the ball, if my memory serves me correct, once, maybe twice so far tonight.
I think
you're
right.
Here's the snap again. Again, Walker on the keeper, gets to the outside, got some room, turns it back in, and gets smothered down in front of the
with the carry to Brantley, that's good for a first down.
That's going to be probably good for a first down in that run there by the quarterback. Kevin?
Yeah, probably the longest play from scrimmage of the night for Brantley County there, and I think he took a hard shot right underneath the face mask there, but he bounced right up, and that was good to see. And I think they need to get him more active too as well, making plays with his legs, rolling out, and making throws on the run or tucking that ball and trying to get some positive yardage. Nice run there by the quarterback, Walker.
With not a whole lot of blockers in front, so good job.
Right.
And now out of the shotgun, the man in motion. And they're going to go ahead and, again, keep it with the quarterback and run it up the middle. That'd
Walker
be good
again
for about 3 or 4 yards. It was Benji O'Neill, 13, that was the man in motion. He was the intended receiver on that pick six that Holloway came away with on the previous possession for Brantley County.
And like you said, not a lot of blocking, and that's really been the Achilles heel for this Herons offense. They're, like I said early in the broadcast, they're really young and thin up front. Graduated a lot of seniors last year when they lined up in that wishbone and double tights and just pounded the ball at people.
So 2 wide as the snap comes to Walker. Walker's got pressure right away, chased out of the pocket. He's going to run it over here to the near side. And he will end
Walker
up getting dragged down again by the middle linebacker,
tackle.
John Phillips Spires.
Will Thompson with the previous
yeah,
tackle.
And once again, his blocking broke down, and he's running for his life back there. Lucky to get away and at least get a couple of yards, I believe, for the Herons there.
Again, it keeps the clock running. And the clock right now in favor of the home team, Frederica Academy. Good pressure up the middle there by the Knights to chase Walker out of the pocket. We're right at a minute to go here in quarter number three. 28-7, Frederica Academy in control. Football right there at the 40-yard line. Here's the snap to Walker. And they're going to go ahead and hand it off. Not a whole lot as they try to run that ball to the outside. The pile continues to move.
Gavin King with the carry for Brantley.
Gavin King on the carry there for Brantley
Game
County.
Three. Fourth and two.
Yeah, looks like Gavin just kept his feet moving and the whistle never blew, so he kind of moved the pile for two or three extra yards there.
Fourth down, let's hear it for the Knights.
Let's see if Brantley gets off one more play here before the end of quarter number three.
10 seconds, time for one more play if they can get the snap off. There it is to Walker low. He's gonna quickly unleash the football. It was batted down.
Pass.
And the intended receiver there for Brantley County was again Middleton. Nice job on the bat down there by number 11, Bryce Riley.
Yeah, good pursuit off the edge. And Walker telegraphed that pass. And good play there by the Frederica defense to bat that down. We will get one more snap, I guess, in the third quarter because there is 1.9 seconds, I think, here to go on the third quarter clock.
So they spot it at the 36-yard line. And we'll see if Brantley County can get something going here in this final snap of the third quarter. Walker will take the snap as he has all game out of done. And it is going to be Walker.
They're
trying to run that ball up the middle and not a whole lot going. That'll bring the third quarter to a close here in St. Simons Island, Georgia. And Frederica Academy in control. They lead Brantley County 28-7 as we take a look at that pick six. Intended for O'Neill, ball batted into the air. And Holloway takes it to the house for the Knights. So we head to the fourth quarter. We're back with more Frederica Academy Knights, Brantley County Herons football, right after this timeout.
Let's get back to business together. Ameris Bank is committed to providing tools you need to do business today. Contactless payment, remote deposit, e-commerce platforms, and more. We're here to make sure you have what you need to operate in today's climate. Learn more at amerisbank.com/backtobusiness.
Golden Owls for 115 years.
Beachview Event Rentals and Design is a full-service event company with a resolution to provide clients with innovative inventory, ideas, and customer service. Our carefully curated collection of tents, lighting, linens, furniture, and tableware are sure to bring your vision to life and create a truly memorable event. The Beachview crew makes sure to bring the creativity, fun, and excellent customer service that has been winning us the appreciation and respect of all our clients for 20 years to each project.
Darien's Fun Waterfront Dining Experience, serving fresh seafood, steaks, and barbecue. Visit our website at skippersfishcamp.com.
You love the game, but you don't love the pain. From the moment an injury sidelines you, turn to the experts at Summit Sports Medicine and Orthopaedic Surgery. Our winning team of physicians and orthopaedic surgeons will design a treatment plan just for you, so you can get back in the game quickly and safely. To play your best, you need to work with the best. Visit sghs.org/summit or call 912-466-7340 to schedule your appointment.
All right, back here at the Richard Hell Sports Center, fourth quarter, as we bring you live webcast coverage tonight for Frederica Academy and Brantley County. Some big plays in this football game, and Frederica Academy has the 28-7 lead as we are early now, Kevin, in the fourth quarter. Good field position again for Frederica Academy. That's kind of been one of the underlying stories of tonight's ball game, is right now they're set to face some.
Yeah, that has been, but they took control of this ball game in the third quarter, going 80 yards to start the second half to score their first touchdown of the second half. Here you go, see them dominated on the ground here again on that play, and then scored again to make it 21-7, and of course had the pick six to really take control of the ball game and make it 28-7. And right now this is just a matter of Frederica keeping this ball on the ground, moving the chains and keeping that clock turning and getting out of here with a convincing victory over Brantley County and former FA assistant.
Well, keeping the ball in the hands of number four, Jordan Triplett, that last run good for a first down. Here's Villa in to the end zone. Well, towards the end zone, it is caught, but it's going to go out of bounds at about the 7-yard line. Nice pass play there. The ball in the hands of Mason McGraw, the senior wide receiver. And McGraw's able to hold on, but the momentum carried him out at about the 7-yard line.
I say keep the ball on the ground, but you know what? Coach Brandon Derrick, the head coach and the offensive play caller, is a former high school and college quarterback himself. He's a Steve Spurrier type, if you will, and he just can't resist throwing that ball to the very end.
So penalty, it looks like, called here against Frederica Academy. That's going to back them up. They had the ball at the 7-yard line. And it will push them back to the 12.
We talked about some of the things Coach Derrick may be noting in his notebook. Some of the bad snaps and penalties could have certainly hurt the Knights here in this ball game. They're going to win the ball game, but that's something they want to iron out as well. Some penalties that could have been costly for the Knights in this ball game, just like that one there.
Everybody checking the plays on their wrist. They're going to hand a football off. It's going to be a run and trying to get to the outside. The ball carrier that time was number 20, Jaden Rose Scally. We've seen a lot of Jordan Triplett tonight, and Rose Scally getting his number called right there to run play. He's able to get close to the 10-yard line, push back to the 11.
Yeah, good pursuit by the Herons there. They started off the ball game doing that, and but it just had not had an answer for Triplett.
Wide out here to the near side is McGraw. Here's the snap. Neal going to throw far side of the field. It is up, and it is caught, and is that a touchdown? Yes, it is. On the receiving end there. Trying to see if that was Eli Fritchman.
I think it may have been number 10, McGraw.
So McGraw, who had the catch three or four plays ago that got them to the 7-yard line, McGraw on the receiving end of the touchdown. Here's Fritchman on the point after. It is up and it is good. And so seven more points up on the board for Frederica Academy. And they have themselves a 34-7 lead. Let's take another look. Maybe see it a little bit better in slow motion. And it is there.
No, you're right. It was
Fritchman. The touchdown. Action, it was Fritchman on the receiving end. That's his second touchdown reception of the football game. And then, of course, he goes and kicks the point after a 10. He makes it a 34-7 ball game. Frederica Academy, awfully impressive, Kevin, here in the second half.
Yeah, you know, they've really come out, and other than the penalties and some of those bad snaps, they have really executed well in this second half, particularly running the football downhill with the Triplett kid. But Bill has been on point with some of those passes. That may have been his best thrown ball of the second half. Really put that on the money Frischman there in the end zone for his second touchdown catch. And, you know, Bill is settling in. This is just his fourth start at the quarterback position this year. And Coach Brandon Derrick alluded to the fact that he was going to get more aggressive with his play calling as they go forward. And he's turning loose Bill here again a little more tonight than he did in the first two ball games. And they're on, I thought they might be onside kicking it there again. But Yeah, I think this Frederica offense is just going to get better and better the more they play.
Colin Vinatero, the senior kicker, handling the kicking duties or the kickoff duties there for Frederica Academy.
With the return,
for Brantley County. 35-7 our score as we play on here in the fourth quarter. That was an 11-touchdown pass.
They'll take over at the 38.
All right, so yeah, we're having some mic issues there with Dave, so Brantley County will go back on offense here. Just over 9 minutes to go in quarter number four. 35-7 your score, the Herons on offense. Dave is back.
So Taiwan Walker in at quarterback. The handoff goes to Middleton, and Middleton was their featured back coming into the ball game at 17 carries, 98 yards. He averaged almost 6 yards a carry. But has largely had trouble moving the football here tonight against the defensive front for Frederica Academy.
Yeah, and again, Middleton, a jack of all trades, running and catching the football, 234 all-purpose yards to lead the Herons, who have struggled offensively all year long.
Snap coming up here on second down, and it's going to be a run here for Middleton. Middleton with a nice forearm gets to the outside, gets run out of bounds in front of the Frederica Knights sideline. That should be good enough for a first down for Brantley County.
Gain of 17. That'll be a first
down. Take another look. Nice block by O'Neill. Opens up a little bit of room, and Middleton, Kevin, able to get to the outside.
And you know, Coach Cannon told me he had Walker not transferred from Ware County before the start of the year, that Middleton would have been the quarterback. And you know, Walker actually took a shot, Dave, if you remember, on that last drive. I'm wondering if he might be a little shaken up as well.
Middleton, it looks like, is in at quarterback. And Middleton takes the snap, going to throw as a left-handed quarterback. That's a tough throw to make as he gets hit from behind as he releases the football. O'Neill was the intended receiver.
Pass incomplete.
So a change at quarterback, yeah. Kevin, for Brantley County.
Yeah, not only was he rolling to his right and throwing across his body, he had pressure coming from the backside, which added to his troubles right there as he was trying to get rid of that football.
Second and 10.
So it'll bring up third down now for Brantley County. Middleton again out of the shotgun. King lines up to his right, trailing 35-7. And it's going to be a keeper there for Middleton. He'll try to run in behind the right tackle. Not a whole lot going on. Right in there is Josh Meadows, number 8, the linebacker.
Middleton,
he's a senior for Frederica Academy. He's one of the first
Josh
in there
Meadows
to make the tackle.
In on the tackle.
Yeah, Frederica only has 30 guys on their roster. I think they may have dressed some like either 26 or 28 tonight, and they have to rotate guys and play rotations, actually, kind of like basketball or hockey. And they spend a lot of time figuring out how to play guys throughout the game and give them rest and whatnot. But Meadows is one of those guys they want to have on the field on either side of the football as much as possible.
Clock continues to run, just under 8 minutes to go in the football game. Again, 35-7, movement along that line by Brantley County. And that's gonna back him up 5 yards.
Flag on the play goes against Brantley.
An offside penalty against Brantley County Herons. So again, not the direction that Brantley County needs to be moving.
Third and 15.
With a big hole to dig out of and not a whole lot of time to do it. Inside of 8 to go. So Middleton in at quarterback in place of Taiwan Walker. O'Neill goes in motion. And it'll be Middleton on the keeper as he tries to push and shove his way in behind the right tackle.
Middleton with the carry.
That should be good for 3 or 4 yards in that play.
Gain of 3.
Yeah, Middleton looks like he's got a little bit of size on him, so he ought to be able to do a little pushing and shoving.
Again, the more they keep the ball on the ground, the longer that clock continues to run.
It's fourth
That's
down.
Right. And in Georgia High,
for that night.
In Georgia High School football, it is a mandatory running clock when the lead is 30 or more, but it has to be at the start of the fourth quarter.
Again, O'Neal goes in motion. And it's a loose football. Frederica Academy recovers it. On the recovery there was 61 for the Knights. That's Jacob Triplett, the senior defensive lineman. Another takeaway.
Yeah, Middleton was trying to hand that football off, or actually I guess he dropped it and then tried to hand it off, and somebody missed the play call there. So miscommunication there by the Herons. And like I said earlier, when it rains, it pours. When you're 0-4, about to go 0-5, you don't get breaks like that. Somebody did not know what play they were running. They put the ball on the ground, and Frederica gets it.
7:03 to go in a 35-7 ball game. And there's a timeout on the field. We'll take the break with them. Back with more. You're watching our coverage tonight of Frederica Academy in Brantley County. We're back with more right after this time.
Let's get back to business together. Ameris Bank is committed to providing tools you need to do business today. Contactless payment, remote deposit, e-commerce platforms, and more. We're here to make sure you have what you need to operate in today's climate. Learn more at amerisbank.com/backtobusiness.
Golden Owls for 115 years.
Beachview Event Rentals and Design is a full-service event company with a resolution to provide clients with innovative inventory, ideas, and customer service. Our carefully curated collection of tents, lighting, linens, furniture, and tableware are sure to bring your vision to life and create a truly memorable event. The Beachview crew makes sure to bring the creativity, fun, and excellent customer service that has been winning us the appreciation and respect of all our clients for 20 years to each project.
Darien's Fun Waterfront Dining Experience, serving fresh seafood, steaks, and barbecue. Visit our website at skippersfishcamp.com.
You love the game, but you don't love the pain. From the moment an injury sidelines you, turn to the experts at Summit Sports Medicine and Orthopaedic Surgery. Our winning team of physicians and orthopaedic surgeons will design a treatment plan just for you, so you can get back in the game quickly and safely. To play your best, you need to work with the best. Visit sghs.org/summit or call 912-466-7340 to schedule your appointment.
Fourth quarter continues here. Frederica Academy has a 35-7 lead over visiting Brantley County as the Knights try to go to 2-2 on the year. And after the turnover, keeping the ball on the ground, a run play there on third down. In on the tackle there for Brantley County. We've called his name a few times tonight. 48 R.J. Bryan, the junior linebacker.
Yeah, he's played a well of a game. And, of course, he had the pick six for Brantley County's only score. Bill's still in there at quarterback for Frederica Academy, but they do have some clean jerseys in there, as you can see, as they don't have a whole lot of guys to go to who haven't played, but they do have a few, I guess, who at least have not played on this side of the ball, primarily for Frederica.
Well, that brought up fourth down, that last play. That's going to bring on the punter, Eli Fritchman. He's been on the receiving end of two touchdown catches tonight and gets a nice kickoff. And it'll take a Frederica Academy bounce, and finally recovered and pounced on by
Eli Fritchman,
the kicking team of the special teams unit there for
with the kick, Brantley will take Brantley, over.
Brantley County. And again, not great field position again for the Herons.
No, and when you have trouble mounting consistent drives or don't have the ability to necessarily strike for the big plays, when you have to go 70, 80, or 90 yards, things of that nature, with an inexperienced offensive front, it's really tough on your football team. And I don't know how much better they can get offensively. Certainly you hope they can improve and find some things they can hang their hat on. But until they can get to where they can mount consistent drives, they're going to need their defense to set them up in some big positions or get some turnovers to give themselves a short field or things, or special teams to make some big plays.
So Middleton stays in at quarterback, and they're going to run that ball up the middle. Nice little second burst there by the ball carrier Middleton on that keeper. And that should be good enough, if not good enough, awfully close to the first down marker.
Gain of 10, that's good enough for a first down.
Yeah, and the thing I understand about Middleton, he's kind of like a kid you would like to have, 30 or 40 of if you could on your high school football team. He's a kid that you can coach. He takes coaching well. He does everything you ask. He's the kind of kid that shows up early, stays late. He's a leader. He kind of gets all the other kids to follow him. And he's just a guy that is going to give you everything he's got all the time.
Well, that was good enough for a first down run on the keeper again, trying to get to the outside over in front of the Brantley County sideline. And that might be good enough for another Brantley County first down on back-to-back runs there by their backup quarterback Middleton, who was in for Walker.
Gain of 12.
Yeah, and if it is, the clock will stop, and I think it is because it looks like they're moving the chains, but if it wasn't, he did not get out of bounds, so the clock was still going to run.
So the snap coming up on second down, far hash. King lined up to his left, and they're going to hand a football off. They'll try to run it right up the middle, and that'll be good for 3 or 4 yards. Ball carrier there, first time we've called the number 22 tonight. That's Devin Wright.
Devin
is a sophomore
Wright with the
running
carry.
Back. And I believe they.
Middleton moving the offense right here, and don't necessarily want to cause any controversy, but it could be that Brantley considers a quarterback change, and the Walker kid, a good enough athlete to certainly maybe move somewhere, possibly running back or wide receiver, and they get the ball in his hands another way.
Well, 16, Bryant Brantley in at quarterback. They're going to hand it off again. It will go to 22, Devin Wright. Wright gets to the outside, broke one tackle, and is brought down. Should be good enough for a first down run there for Brantley County.
Yeah, good positive run for him as well. Runs it into the teeth of the defense. Sees he has nowhere to go, bounces it outside, and gets positive yardage.
So again, third quarterback of the night we've seen for Brantley County. Started out with Walker, saw Middleton, and now it is 16, Brian Brantley, the junior. In the backfield is Wright. There's a snap. They'll hand it off to Wright again, but there's whistles.
Yeah, false start on the offense.
So that'll bring them back 5 yards, which is tough. It's been one of the better drives we've seen tonight, at least here in the second half for the Herons.
Yeah, and those are the kind of things that just have to kill Coach Cannon. I mean, you get something going that's positive, and, they're just not consistent enough to overcome things like that. So when you have stuff going that's positive, you can't do stuff like this that sets you back.
So Brantley out of the shotgun, a high snap. He's able to jump, bring it down, hand it off to Devin Wright. But by the time Wright gets his hands on the football, a lot of green jerseys are there to make the tackle.
Get on the tackle for the Knights.
That's right. And again, the timing of that play thrown off by a high snap. And those, again, are the kinds of things that will just hurt an offense like this that has trouble mounting consistent drives. You can't have these little mistakes to just throw you off. You got to continue to churn out yards 2, 3, 4, 5 yards at a time. These little mistakes like that, they're not good enough to overcome.
In on the tackle there for Frederica Academy, 33, Jacob Aiken, one of the inside linebackers. Here's the snap, and it's going to be given to King. King is going to run to the far sideline, going to lower that left shoulder, try to get to that first down marker.
Gavin King.
And let's see where they spot the football.
It's going to be close, and we'll see if they give him a favorable spot. But, yeah, once he got to the corner, he turned it upfield, got north and south behind his pads, like you said, lowered his shoulder, dared somebody to come after him, and he was bound and determined to get to that yard marker. And let's see where they did actually spot it. Looks like it's going to be pretty close here. About a yard short.
Shy by about a, about a yard. And they're too wide here to the near side, as you can see. Brantley again out of the shotgun. Wright and King in the backfield. Again, another high snap. Brantley off his back foot, going to throw in and out of the hands of the intended receiver, Quentin Walker.
Pass is incomplete.
And that's an incomplete
intended
pass.
For Quentin Walker.
High snap for sure, but yeah, the quarterback did a good job, Brantley, of getting that football and getting rid of it. And ball should have been caught.
The fan of the game.
And should have been a first down.
Today that goes to Kenny Quinn. Kenny, you.
So they will stop the clock at 42 seconds.
Looks like they might have gained about a half yard on the spot there.
Here's the snap. Brantley, again, going to unload the football downfield. And it is caught by Walker. And Quentin Walker gets tackled heading to the end zone.
Pass complete to Quentin
Walker. And rushing
Walker.
Back to make that tackle again was Jacob Aiken. But maybe the nicest pass play we've seen tonight from Brantley County, Kevin.
First down for Brantley.
You're probably right. They threw it up, and they come down with it. He just actually waited on it to come down.
And the two top plays we've seen tonight defensively have been by seven. Quentin Walker, that's one of the top plays offensively.
That's right.
Here's the snap again to Brantley. They're going to keep it on the ground. On the carry is Devin Wright. And that might be the final play of the ball game. Nope, they stopped the clock just inside of 10 seconds.
Timeout taken by the Harriers.
Timeout,
yeah, Brantley called a timeout.
By Brantley County.
Fans, remember, there will be no gathering after the game.
But they can certainly leave on a positive note if they can get into the end zone.
That's right. They've yet to score an offensive touchdown in this game. They've only scored 13 points on the season. So they're going to fight it out to the end here and see if they can punch it in just to show themselves, if not anything else, that they can put the ball into the end zone with their offense.
-7 our score coming out of this timeout. We'll see what Frederica can do defensively. Again, Brantley County trying to close out on a positive note. Frederica Academy will be in action again next Friday, October the 9th. Long County will be visiting St. Simons. That'll be homecoming. And October 9th, next week, Cook County at Adel, Georgia for Brantley County. Taking a look forward on the schedules of these two teams. Here's Brantley, and he's going to play action, going to throw, and it's going to be batted down. And that'll stop the clock with 5.1 seconds to go.
Incomplete.
So we'll get another snap off at least. And, of course, the game cannot end on a defensive penalty. Yeah, Long County will be another GHSA school. So Coach Brandon Derrick has put a few GHSA schools on the schedule once again. He's a guy who is not afraid to play GHSA teams. Of course, GISA schools and GHSA schools have not always been able to play each other, but in recent years they have. And Coach Brandon Derrick not afraid to reach out to GHSA schools and see if they'll play.
So here's the snap, could be the final play. And Brantley's going to roll out, going to dump it towards the end zone. And
that
it was it incomplete?
Incomplete.
Yes, it was incomplete.
And your
Jaden Scally-Rose has the
Frederica
football.
Academy, nice.
And there's 1 second
35.
Left. Well, the scoreboard shows that the game is over.
Seven.
And
everyone have a great weekend.
It'll be a 35-7 final score in favor of the home team.
Thanks
the
for
Frederica
coming.
Academy Knights going to improve to 2-2 on the year. 0-5 the record now for Brantley County. So, Kevin. So, Kevin, a final score, 35-7. Some big plays tonight. Frederica Academy, once they jumped out early, 14-7. As you said many times, it would be tough for Brantley County to come back and score enough points to go to with them toe-to-toe.
Yeah, the third quarter, a big quarter for Frederica Academy. Took charge of this game after leading 8-7 at the half. Obviously, they could have really closed the half with a bang after getting that safety, but had that ball go out of bounds on them. And it stayed at 8-7, but took charge in the third quarter with three scores to go up 28-7. They were in control at that point because Brantley County has had trouble scoring points all year long. As we saw, could not score in the second half, and Frederica wins this ball game going away.
And again, as you mentioned, third quarter, those three scores, two of them from Jordan Triplett, 24-yard touchdown run, a 3-yard touchdown run, and then another big play, the pick six, Blake Holloway, to the end zone, and that's really all they needed. Kevin, good to work with you tonight, and good ball game tonight, a good win for Frederica Academy.
Yes, it was. I was looking forward to this ball game all year, Frederica against Brantley County. Coach Jeff Cannon from Brantley, a former assistant, coming back to St. Simon's Island to take on his good friend, Brandon Derrick. Looking forward to this ball game all night long. And, of course, a great ball game, great atmosphere on St. Simon's Island. Good luck to Frederica Academy the rest of the way. I enjoyed it, guys. And y'all guys take care. We'll see you down the road.
35-7, the final score.